don't think art should necessarily reflect life, especially life as it is today.
Exactly. And I recognize other schools of art, only I don't like them.
I just found that
romanticism.
I just found that a little bit contradictory with Ben when she said, in terms of religion, that she didn't believe in religion as we do because it's not based on realism, as she said, and more mysticism.
You're mixing categories. You see, the issue of religion is metaphysical. It's so in nature, in reality. Now, art is not metaphysics. It's not there without man. Art is man-made. It's a product of man. And when it's a product of man, you don't have to copy it. You don't have to say this is a fact because 10 men did it that way. You create your own art, or you like a school of which there's only one representative. Anything that is man-made is open to reason, but not by the same kind of mental process as metaphysical or scientific factual issues. For instance, here I can only recommend that you read my book, The Romantic Manifesto, because I couldn't cover it in a few minutes. The reasons why I can demonstrate to you that Romanticism is the best school of art, the best, most justifiable, but not the only one.
You liked Charlie's Angels?
Yes.
Because why?
Because it's the only romantic television show today. It's not realistic. It's not about the gutter. It's not about the half-wit retarded children and all the other kind of shows today. It's about three attractive girls doing impossible things. And because they're impossible, that's what makes it interesting. It shows three young girls who are better than so-called real life.
Yeah, and you like
that. That's a romantic school of literature.
You want art to be romantic, don't you?
Oh, sir.
You're not crazy, then, about art which reflects life?
Not the life of the moment. Well, I want art that reflects life long range.
Were there books or writers that influenced you in those formative years?
Only one. One philosopher and one writer. As far as writers go, Victor Hugo, whom I discovered at 13, and that was the greatest literary experience I ever had, incomparable and incommunicable. I admired him enormously. The sense of lives that he communicated, the glamour, the grandeur of men, was so high above anything I had encountered in any other books, and certainly in another universe as compared to the reality of Soviet Russia, that I, to this day, owe an enormous debt of gratitude to Victor Hugo. And it's from him, in effect, that I learned the art of the romantic novel in a serious sense of the word, the integration of plot, of action, with the theme and the philosophical meaning of a book. I don't agree with his philosophy, but I admire him as a writer tremendously.
How was writing novels difficult for you?
Because it's an enormous context that you have to keep in mind, an enormous structure. You can't do it inspirationally. You can't do it by just looking at a piece of paper once and deciding what you're going to do. It's a whole enormous structure, much more complicated than a building. And you have to keep it all in mind, never contradict your outline, and carry it out. It's killingly difficult, but wonderful when you succeed at it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean a good novel, of course.
Why do you object to, or why do you not like, novels which are close to life as it really is, naturalism?
Because I don't think it's art.
It's not art.
It's partly art. In other words, a naturalistic novel is an incomplete work of art. It has certain elements of art, such as characterization, or some of them have a good style. All that is artistic. But art primarily, and that I can prove philosophically, is a recreation of reality, not a photograph. Art is not journalism. It is a recreation of reality according to an author's metaphysical value judgments. Metaphysical.
Does that mean that
meaning.
You write only about what ought to be, not what is?
Yes, but let me finish. I use the big words, so I want to be sure that the audience does understand me. By metaphysical, I mean the nature of reality as such, the nature of existence. It's his view of man and of the nature of existence that a writer or any artist really expresses in art. And romantic art presents to man what he might be and ought to be. That is, it presents an ideal and tells man this is the essential nature of man, and you as a human being can become that if you wish. So that art in that sense, romantic art, is model building. Not, however, and I emphasize that, not for the purpose of improving or teaching your something to your readers.
Not teaching.
Oh, not teaching. Art should never be didactic. That's a secondary issue. That's pure gravy. The primary purpose of art is contemplation for its own sake. So that the purpose here is for the reader to see what greatness man is capable of and to be inspired by that.
So as I read Atlas Shrugged, then, and any one of the heroic characters, Hank Reardon or John Galt or Francisco, these give me a model of the kind of person I might be?
If you wish, but that isn't my purpose in writing.
I see.
My purpose is for you to look at those people and to enjoy the spectacle. As a secondary consequence, you might find yourself inspired. Yes. That's fine. But I want to give you that experience. And that's what I want to give myself. I write for the purpose of creating an ideal man in actions which you can respect and admire.
From what you say about art, I would judge you do not regard photography as art, since it records precisely what is there. How do you feel about abstract art?
Do you mean non-objective?
Non-objective, yes.
I think it's less art than photography. I think it is an enormous fraud.
Fraud?
Yes. Mm. I don't think there's... it's impossible to discuss it seriously. Mm. It means nothing. It is nothing. The perpetrators claim that they don't know what they're doing. And I think they're right. I'm willing to take them at their word. They don't know what they're doing, and neither do we. And the ash can is the proper place for it. But I mean it seriously.
Who are some of your favorite writers of novels?
My favorite writers? Victor Hugo, Dostoevsky, or Henry. That, I think, is enough.